Hi everyone, in this video I am going to discuss about how to construct a half pyramid using a star. Okay, so I just want to place a star and I want to construct a half pyramid structure, right? So let us first discuss how to write a code. See, initially we have to draw the grid. Because without drawing the grids, it is very difficult to understand where exactly we have to place a star and how many stars we have to place in each row. So therefore, initially I have drawn a grid for 5 rows and 5 columns. So let us write a code. So here we have declared 3 variables, that is I, j and rows. So the rows variable is used to construct a half pyramid till how many rows. So that particular information will be present in a rows variable. Suppose if I enter a rows as a say 3. So what happens till 3 rows, a half pyramid will be constructed with a star like this. So this is one star, second, third. Like this it will be constructed. So this is row 1, row 2 and this is row 3. Suppose if I enter a 5, so then what happens up to 5th row, a half pyramid will be constructed like this. Star, here we will draw the star in this way. So this is 4th row and this is 5th row. Like this. Fine. So that purpose we have used rows variable here, and I and j will be used to point to which row and which column. So suppose if I want to place a star at this cell, so then I have to identify this cell. This particular cell is identified by its row value and column value. Okay, so this is row 0, this is column 0, column 1, 2, 3, 4, and this is 1, 2, 3, 4 here. So total how many rows we are having? 5 rows and 5 columns we are having. Suppose if I want to put a star in this cell, this is called a cell. Okay, so all these are called as a cell. Suppose if I put a star in this particular cell, then I have to identify this cell. So this cell is identified by using row value and the column value. So suppose if I write 0 comma 0 equal to star, then what happens? The star will be placed here. Okay, so similarly, suppose if I want to put a star in this particular location, so then this is identified as, that is 4th row, which column? 4th column. Then if I write a star, so star will be placed here. Okay, so now let us write a code to place a star so that a half pyramid should be constructed. Okay, so usually in half pyramid what happens, we will put a first star in first cell, and after that we will come to second row. In a second row, in a consecutive cells, we will place a 2 star. After that we don't continue it till 5 column, but we will break there itself and we will come to third row and we will place 3 stars and so on. So this is actually the operation what we should do here. Okay, so now let us write a code. So initially we are writing a printf statement to ask the user to enter how many rows, till how many rows a half pyramid has to be constructed. Okay, and a user will enter a row value. Suppose a user enters a row value as a 5, then 5 will be stored in rows variable. So assume this is a rows variable and a memory is allocated for this, and a 5 will be stored inside this memory location. So next, what we are doing, we are writing a for loop. So for I is equal to 1 means I will start pointing to this location. So I will always representing a row, and I is less than or equal to rows. So what is the value of I? I value is 1. 1 less than or equal to 5. Yes, this condition is satisfied. It will enter inside a loop. So inside loop, another loop we are having, that is a nested loop. So we are initializing j equal to what here? 1. So j will point to this location. Okay. And j is less than or equal to a. So what is the value of j? 1. What is the value of I? It is also 1. So 1 is not less than, but it is equal. So the condition is satisfied and it will enter inside. So now I and j are pointing at which location? I is pointing to first location, j is also pointing to first location. So nothing but this particular cell it is representing. So next, what we do, we just write a printf statement to put a star inside this cell. So when this statement is executed, a star will be placed here. Okay, so the first star we have placed in first cell. So what is next? We don't want to continue till 4 consecutive memory locations, consecutive squares here. Just I want to come down and I want to put 2 star at these 2 cells. So what happens? Again, it will go back. Control will go back to this inner for loop. Okay. So when it go back to inner for loop, j value will be incremented by 1. So j value becomes j plus 1. So therefore, j becomes what here? 2. So again, this condition will be checked. 2 is less than or equal to, what is the value of I? 1. So this condition is failed. Then what happens? It will come out from the loop. Okay, it will exit from the loop. So the outer loop will be continuously executing. So next it will go back to outer loop. So I value will be incremented by 1 because of this statement. Okay, I value becomes 2. Means I will start pointing to this location. So now where is I is pointing? The second row. So next condition will be checked, that is I value is 2. So 2 is less than or equal to rows. Yes, it is true, because what is the value of I? I value is 2. It is less than or equal to 5. So the condition is satisfied. It will get inside. Again, this is reinitialized. Okay. So j value is initialized to 1. So it means that j is pointing to first column. Okay, j is pointing to first column, but I is pointing to second row, nothing but this cell. So j value is what here? 1. 1 is less than, so j value is 1. 1 is less than or equal to what here? What is the value of I here? That is 2. So 1 is less than or equal to 2. Yes. So this condition is satisfied. So when this is satisfied, first what happens? A printf star will be placed. So star will be placed. Again, it will go back. Okay. So here j value will be incremented by 1. Means j becomes 2. So what is the condition now? So the condition is, yes, the condition is, so j value is what here? Now j value is 2. So j value is 2. I value is also what here? 2. So j is less than or equal to what here? I, nothing but 2. Okay, I. So this is equal to 2 is less than or equal to 2. The condition is satisfied. It is not less than, but it is equal. So what happens? J will be pointing to this location. Okay, so instead this, it will start pointing to this location. So now this cell is what here represented by I value and J value. So here a star will be placed. So again, what happens? It will go back. Once loop is executed, inner loop is executed, it will go back. J value is again incremented by 1. So now the J value becomes 3. So 3 less than or equal to what is the value of I here? I value is 2. So neither 3 is equal to 2 nor it is less than 2. So therefore condition will be fake. Then what happens? It will come out. It will come out. Okay. So next outer loop will be executed. So here value of I becomes what here? Earlier it was 2, now it is 3. It is incremented by 1. So I value is 3 became. Okay, becomes 3 now. So now the condition is what here? I less than or equal to 5. Yes, this is 2 because I value is 3. So again it will get inside and this will be executed 3 times. Okay, and again it will go back. Okay, fourth time it will fail. Again I value is incremented by 1. So I value becomes what here? 4 now. So I less than or equal to 5, the condition is true. It will enter inside and this particular loop will be executed 4 times. Okay, so how many times it will be executed? It executes the value of I till the value of I. Okay, so therefore all the stars will be inserted here. 4 stars will be inserted here. Okay, when value of J becomes 5, this condition will be failed. It will come out. Again, it will go back. The outer loop will continue its execution. So now I value becomes what here? I value becomes say 5. So I less than or equal to 5. Yes, this condition is true. It will get inside. Okay. So, and this will be repeated till what is the value of J? 1. Less than or equal to what is the value of I? 5. So means a 5 stars will be placed in this location. Okay, and when J value becomes 5, this condition will be failed. It will come out and outer loop will be continued its execution. So now value of I becomes what here? 6. So 6 means say what is the value of I? 6. What is the value of rows here? 5. So this condition will fail. Therefore it will not get inside the loop. This will not be executed. This will not be executed and directly this statement will be executed and it will stop here itself. I think this video is useful for you. Hope you will understand. Thank you.